Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Free, free Palestine!
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 My respected elders, my brothers and sisters, allow me to greet you in the universal greeting of peace, Assalamu alaikum. It pains me to stand here before you with memories of my visit to Palestine, where I have fond memories of meeting our Palestinian brothers and sisters, more in particular, Brother Hamdi, who was able to take me around Palestine, took me to Jericho, took me to Ramallah, where I saw a statue of my grandfather standing very tall with the words inscribed in it, "Our freedom is incomplete as South Africans without the freedom of the Palestinian." Hamdi took me to visit Hebron and showed me the brutality of the apartheid Israel regime. It was there during my stay in Palestine that I received a call from the South African Jewish Board of Deputies. They called on me and pleaded with me to visit their leadership and in particular their president. I said they must recall my grandfather's words when he undertook to take on the talks with the apartheid regime. It was on a simple spirit that the apartheid regime must unban all political parties, must release all political prisoners, and allow the right of return of all South Africans living in exile. I therefore shared the same sentiments to the South African Jewish Board of Deputies. I said, under no circumstances will I be prepared to meet with the Israeli apartheid regime. I will only do so if they meet three conditions: to immediately release all Palestinian political prisoners, to immediately allow all Palestinians in exile to have the right of return, and to ensure that all political parties in Palestine are unbanned and welcomed to negotiations. It is therefore in that spirit, my respected elders, that I stand here today as we feel the pain and loss of Palestinian families whose loved ones have been killed by the indiscriminate killing machine that masquerades in the garb of the only democracy in the Middle East. Whilst we mourn their loss, we must not be fooled. Apartheid Israel's brutality has continued unabated since the start of the Nakba in 1948 and will not cease as long as the world stands by in silence, whilst innocent civilians are maimed and killed, and 6 million Palestinian refugees are denied the right of return. We must charge apartheid Israel for the genocide and crimes against humanity as its hands has been slowly dripping with blood of our Palestinian brothers and sisters. Long before the current killings in Palestine and Gaza in particular, we support our South African government and other UN member states that have called for an independent inquiry into the most recent killings and hold those responsible accountable for these heinous actions. In Gaza last night, the number of martyrs in the peaceful right of return march now stand at 53, with 6 children having been killed. The number of casualties now has risen to 2,771. Yesterday alone, there were 1,760 casualties, including 1,674 males and 80 females, of which 1,535 were adults and 255 were children. 1,359 of these were as a result of gunshot wounds, 80 of tear gas related, and 14 from rubber bullets, and over 307 from other causes. On the West Bank yesterday, we also saw Israeli brutality akin to the apartheid South Africa's brutality in its darkest days in the 1980s and in the 1990s, as it occupied the roofs of Palestinian houses in the area of Asida, north of Hebron. In Bethlehem district, confrontation broke out in the towns of Takwa. The Israeli occupation forces also closed several roads, leading to Ramallah to prevent the right of return. At the Kalandia checkpoint, a mass rally also arrived in support of the right of return march, breaking the siege and rejecting Trump's decision on Jerusalem. In Deir Nazam village, north of Ramallah, a young man was shot dead in clashes with the brutal Israeli occupation forces. In the light of rising number of casualties and the martyr, especially in Gaza, we make an urgent appeal on all relief and humanitarian agencies, especially those in South Africa, to respond to the plea for assistance in the supply of medical supplies to the hospitals in Gaza, as they are running dangerously low due to the amount of Palestinians killed in injury. It is anticipated, my respected elders and brothers and sisters, that the number of killings and injured will even be higher today, as the 15th marks the 70th Nakba Day. We call on Minister Lindiwe Sisulu and our head of mission to the United Nations to call for an urgent debate and condemn the continued acts of brutality and killing of innocent Palestinians, as well as the implementation of UN resolutions on the right of return. We applaud the recall of Ambassador Sisa Ngobane and say that this is long overdue. But we must not stop there. We call on the South African government to take further action and expel the Israeli ambassador with immediate effect as an act of protest. South Africa must rise and take on Madiba's call to respond to what he coined as the greatest moral issue of our time. We must stop this indiscriminate killings. We must stop the illegal occupation. We must demand the right of return of all Palestinians. Forward with a free, free Palestine. Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
I thank you.